Welcome to NHL Network's countdown of the top 25 playoff moments. I'm Scott Braun. In the next half hour, we revisit the best moments in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Moments of pure heartbreak for some and complete joy for the rest. We start off in the 1994 Eastern Conference Finals. The Rangers with their backs against the wall and their captain guaranteed victory.
Obviously, when I woke up the next day and saw the headline smashed with, I'm going to guarantee a win, I kind of wanted to roll back into the covers and say, call it a day.
The New York Rangers trailed the Devils 3-2 in the series and 2-1 in Game 6, entering the third period. 20 minutes away from elimination, Captain Mark Messier backed up his guarantee.
Here's Alexei Kovalev. He has the Ranger goal.
For the empty net, Mark Messier. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? He said we will win Game 6. He has just picked up the hat trick.
Broussard trying to stagger free. Meanwhile, it's played along to him. Centering pass flagged down by Green. Played into traffic, though. Starting back up with it now is Martinez in a 3-on-2. Clifford gave it across. It's held in a shot. Safe.
Martinez scored the OT winner in Game 7 in the Western Conference Finals against the Chicago Blackhawks. And he does it again to win the Stanley Cup.
Game 7 of the 1987 Pacific Division semifinals was given the nickname the Easter Epic as the Islanders and Capitals went deep into the night and a fourth overtime before Pat LaFontaine sent everyone home.
Janina Butt shoots at a stick. Comes to the line. LaFontaine shot. He scores! LaFontaine at the blue line. Here in the fourth overtime. Firing the shot and winning the series. Scoring at 8:47 of a fourth overtime period. And the Islanders pour off the bench. And the Capitals stand there exhausted with their heads hanging low. But they got to keep their heads up for putting a show up like this.
Behind the defense, walks in, makes a move. He shoots and scores! Mario Lemieux just beat Hextall. The circles go to Harry, walks right in, Harry's in front. Lemieux scores! Mario Lemieux gets his second. The Penguins lead 2-0. Lemieux back into the fires in by himself. Cuts in, shoot. He scores! The hat trick for Mario Lemieux! Challenged by Howell, gave it right behind the net. Here's Lemieux, putting it in the bucket. That would have tied an NHL record had it gone in. It comes free now. Here's Lemieux there. He does get the record and tie it. And ties the record for the most goals. And also the most points in one game. Absolutely unbelievable. Mario Lemieux.
My boy. Lying down.
Maple Leafs defenseman Bob Bond suffered a fractured ankle in Game 6 of the 1964 Stanley Cup Final and was carried off the ice. But he returned to the ice in overtime and stole the show.
The board, Bob Bond lets it drive, it goes, scores! Bob Bond let it go and bounced and went into the net. And it's all over. And the series is tied.
And when I went into the faceoff with Gordie Howe, I just heard a snap and it caved in underneath me, and I tried to get up, and there's no way I could put any weight on it. So that was the story then, and they froze my leg then, and it's all right now. Of course, I can't feel it.
One of many historic memories between the Montreal Canadiens and Boston Bruins, Game 2 of the 1971 Stanley Cup quarterfinals was one for the history books. The Bruins jumped out to a 5-1 lead before the Habs lit the lamp six consecutive times.
Four, trying to shift on Richard. He's got daylight. In on Johnston. Scores. Inside, Cordway tries to stuff it home, and Béliveau scores. It's 5-3. And here's Béliveau moving in. Backhander scores, and now it's down to seat-squirming time. It's 5-4. out to Orr, but here comes a breakaway, Jacques Lemaire. Lemaire a breakaway, and it's all tied up 5-5. Dallas Smith trying to tie it up. Out front, scored Ferguson, and the Canadians have gone back out in front, 6-5. Lead pass to Mahovlich, walking home on Johnston, and he scores. It's 7-5 Montreal.
Montreal won 7-5 and took the series in seven games.
Back to be taken by Campbell. Here's Campbell handing on to Kane again. Lots of head fakes there, trying to shake Steven. Threw one in front. It rattled around and it kicked on back and then score! We saw no light, we saw no signal, and we're not sure if they've sent a signal of a goal yet, but they are celebrating at the other end of the ice. What chaos!
Patrick Kane with the shot. Oh, that puck is in. It ends up in the far back side.
Word has gotten to the Blackhawks what you have just seen. One of the more unusual finishes, but it's a goal. The Stanley Cup to the Chicago Blackhawks.
Game 2 of the Smythe Division semifinals, a.k.a. the Miracle on Manchester, took place in L.A. as the Edmonton Oilers faced the Kings. Los Angeles trailed 5-0 in the third period, but they roared all the way back to force overtime.
And Bozak, an all-rookie front line. Wells and Chartra back. Smith on the draw. Shot by Evans, he scores! Oh!
Darrell Evans completed the comeback for the Kings, and they later won the series 3-2, taking down the number one seed Oilers. The Detroit Red Wings won their second consecutive Stanley Cup in 1998, but that wasn't the main story. In the summer of 1997, Detroit's Vladimir Konstantinov was involved in a career-ending limousine accident. Konstantinov was brought out onto the ice for their championship celebration with his teammates following their victory. The Red Wings rallied to the catchphrase of "Believe" and wore a patch with his initials.
The warmth and humidity in the arena have caused a layer of fog to gather and swirl along the cold surface of the ice. And soon the players seem to be skating on soft cushions of mist, floating along the ice without really touching it. 14 times before the end of this game, play is stopped while both teams skate around in tight circles at either end of the rink, causing drafts that temporarily lift the fog.
Around comes to Rick Martin, up ahead for Perro. Perro coming to center, dumps it off the boards in the corner. Robert going after it, he scores!
The scoreboard reads under period 8. We are on fifth overtime. Nicholas Hatlett will move it ahead. Off the red line, shoot it around. Turco couldn't get on with it. LeClaire, in by Hatlett. The shot!
Hopefully the show isn't putting you to sleep yet. Coming up on the Top 25 Playoff Moments, a game that went deep into the night at the Igloo, and a Blackhawks comeback that happened in the blink of an eye.
By Keith around for a beat in front. Score! Tapes to Beckles! Avalanche have won the Stanley Cup!
My best memories of the 5-overtime victory over the Pittsburgh Penguins was the fact that it was a night that just seemed to never end. We went through pizzas in the locker room. We went through power gels, power bars, everything that we could possibly eat in that locker room, we ate. And as the night wore on, it actually turned into more of a comedy fest than anything. Guys were laughing in between periods, asking for somebody to please end this affair. A night that I'll never forget. A night that I would never want to repeat because I was dog tired when it was all over. And that victory right there was basically the series. When we won that game, we knew that Pittsburgh was dead.
The Flyers trailed the Penguins 2-1 in the series, entering Game 4 of the 2000 Eastern Conference semifinals. Fans were falling asleep at the Igloo as this one went to a fifth overtime.
Off the bench, is onside. Remo moves deep with it, stops the shot!
Alex Ovechkin netted a hat trick, and later on in the game, Crosby would also score three. But Sid the Kid's efforts weren't enough as the Caps won the game 4-3. However, the Pens won the series in seven and went on to win their third Stanley Cup. Game one of the 1990 Stanley Cup Final between the Oilers and Bruins would go down in history. A 2-2 tie was taken deep into the third overtime, but it was Peter Klima who ended the longest game in Cup history.
McTavish and Curry. Klima catching up. He's in. She scores! Klima gets the goal for the Edmonton Oilers here in the third overtime at 15-13. And what a win this has got to be for the Edmonton Oilers.
To the bench is Crawford. Extra attacker out in the net empty. They battle in the corner. It's finessed by Keith around for a feed in front. Score! Tames to Bickle with 1:16 to go in the third. Here's one thrown by Brolik that's blocked away by Rask. Help to the back. Oduya shot deflected. Spammel. They score! Ballin 3-2 with less than a minute to go. Two goals in 17 seconds. From a 2-1 deficit, a 3-2 lead. The Blackhawks are Stanley Cup champions.
Game one of the 1936 Stanley Cup semifinals between the Red Wings and Montreal Maroons went six overtimes before it finally came to a close.
Kilray loses control of the puck. It dribbles over towards Montreal. Brunetto, who comes tearing in. Brunetto takes a whack at it. He scores!
The Red Wings went on to win their first ever Stanley Cup. Up next, a 54-year curse is on the line at Madison Square Garden.
The Devils score! 7.7 seconds to go. The Rangers were 7.7 seconds away from the Stanley Cup final.
High drama in a game seven. See how it ended when NHL Network's countdown returns. In Game 7 of the 1994 Eastern Conference Finals, the Rangers had a 1-0 advantage in the waning seconds of regulation. With a mad scramble in front of Rangers goalie Mike Richter, New Jersey's Valeri Zelipukin was able to get one by him to tie the game with 7.7 seconds remaining to force overtime. The Rangers, who hadn't won a Stanley Cup in 54 years, went to a double overtime and a New York legend was born.
Blocked to the near side corner, John McClain. Off Grobler's shoulder, it's still in play. Batisov blocked by Zatikina.
Matteau swoops in to intercept. Matteau behind the net, swings it in front. He scores! Matteau! Defend Matteau! And the Rangers have one more hill to climb, baby. But it's North Vancouver. The Rangers are headed to the final.
Stefan Matteau, his second overtime goal. Series, and the Rangers have won it 2-1 in double overtime.
1979 Stanley Cup semifinals. Canadiens, Bruins, Game 7. Up 4-3 late in the third, the Bruins are called for too many men on the ice, giving the Habs a power play with 2:34 left in regulation.
Boston 4, Montreal 3. Lafleur coming out rather gingerly on the right side. He gives it into Lemaire, back to Lafleur.
Guy Lafleur's game-tying power play goal sent this one to overtime.
Here's Tremblay hitting the Boston line. Tremblay cutting, centering it right to the goal. They score! Tremblay! Yvon Lambert from the doorstep of Phil Gilbert sends the Montreal Forum into a frenzy.
It's just emotional. You've dreamt about it. I dreamt about it. It's unbelievable.
Tonelli, the Neister, he scores! Bob Neister scores the goal. The Islanders win the Stanley Cup.
The top five playoff moments are coming up. Which one Stanley Cup final moment topped all of them? Keep it right here. Hall of Fame defenseman Ray Bourque spent his first 21 NHL seasons with the Boston Bruins, amassing over 1,500 points. But the Bees legend was never able to hoist the Stanley Cup over his head while wearing the Boston crest on his jersey. The Bruins traded Bourque to the Colorado Avalanche in the 1999-2000 season, and the following season, the Avs reached the Stanley Cup final. Game 7 saw the Avalanche lead the New Jersey Devils 3-1. And with just 13 seconds left in the game, veteran Ray Bourque was on the verge of his first and only Stanley Cup.
So much heart, so much character. We kept it together, came back and won it at home. And all year long, we said, home ice was going to be a key, and it turned out it was.
No player in history waited longer than Bourque to win his first Stanley Cup, playing 22 years with over 200 playoff games under his belt. Bourque would be inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2004.
Shot to the line, Stevens kept it in. Powell flipped it, it hit Stevens. He put it in wide of the net for Eliash to dig it out. Right in front, they score! The Stanley Cup goal is scored by Arnott. The New Jersey Devils are celebrating. Ed Belfour is in shock, just now getting up. 2-1, the Devils win Game 6. The Devils of New Jersey have won the Stanley Cup.
54 years of heartache. The chant of "We want the cup." This is the moment they have waited for a lifetime.
A lot of toilet paper on the ice. They're waiting to have that all cleared up before the puck will be dropped.
Here it is. The waiting is over. The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions. And this one will last a lifetime! Let the celebration begin.
Four ties, 7 minutes gone in overtime. Henning. Pass right on the stick of Tonelli. Coming in with Nystrom. Tonelli to Nystrom. He scores!
Bobby Nystrom's overtime game-winning goal in Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final propelled the New York Islanders to the first of four consecutive Stanley Cup victories.
West ball rolled in front of Anderson. Tried to shot that was wide and keen and cleared it but not out. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores for the Boston Bruins! There's Bobby Orr, the man that scored the winning goal. A roar from the crowd. Just listen to them.
That wraps up this NHL Network's countdown of the top 25 playoff moments. We hope you enjoyed it. Let the debates of our rankings begin. For everyone at NHL Network, I'm Scott Braun. We'll see you next time.